G'day and welcome back to the Project 200 build series. Today I'm going to be replacing the LandCruiser's standard dual batteries, replacing one with a high current starting battery and the other with a deep cycle battery to run most of the accessories. This means splitting the batteries from the parallel factory configuration, with the deep cycle battery being charged by a DC to DC charger instead of the alternator. The starting battery will be an Australian made Century Overlander. The Overlander has a very high cranking amp rating, which is important since it's replacing two starting batteries. It also has a semi-cycling capability, so it can handle being discharged, for example during extended winching, without suffering damage. The Overlander's got several design features that resist vibration, which is obviously very important for long life in a four-wheel drive. The accessory battery is another Australian-made Century. This time though, it's a flooded 100 amp hour deep cycle, which is more resistant to heat than most AGM or gel type deep cycle batteries, making it ideal for underbonnet use. Plus, it has a 25% higher amp hour rating than an Optima AGM battery of the same size. For more info on the pros and cons of the various types of deep cycle batteries, visit the Project 200 website. Charging the deep cycle battery will be this Redarc 25 amp DC to DC charger. The charger is Australian made, weatherproof, and operates down to input voltages as low as 9 volts, which is far lower than the Chinese alternatives. Although I'm not installing any solar panels at this time, the charger also has a solar input which can keep the battery charged while you're camping, and it will use available solar power even when the engine's running, reducing the load on the alternator. The charger will be installed between the grill and the radiator using this excellent little bracket made by the Long Ranger for out-of-town four-wheel drive. The advantage of using this bracket is that it keeps the charger out of the heat of the engine bay so it operates at maximum efficiency. Please enjoy this step-by-step guide to splitting the dual batteries on the LandCruiser 200 and installing a Redarc dual input DC to DC charger. Begin the installation by removing the front underbonnet trim panel. It's retained by 7 reusable clips, which are removed by pressing in the centre and lifting out the clip. You can then move on to the batteries. Disconnect the negative terminal of both batteries by loosening the terminals with a 10mm spanner. With the negative terminal clamps removed, you can then disconnect the positive terminal clamps of each battery, ensuring the cables can't come back into contact with the battery terminals. With all the electrical cables disconnected, you can then undo each battery's securing clamps using a 12mm socket and lift each battery out of the vehicle. Next, you can remove the cable that joined the two positive terminals together. The clamps holding this cable can be undone by inserting a flat screwdriver into the slot and twisting it. I'm also relocating the supply cables for the winch and the driving lights over to the starting battery, because these accessories will work far better when attached to the battery being fed by the 140 amp alternator rather than the DC to DC charger. You can now begin preparing all the wiring for the DC to DC charger and FK40 fuse holders. With cable lengths of up to 5 metres, such as for this installation, the supply and charge cables should both be at least 8 square millimetres in size. Cut the supply and charge cables you'll be using to the appropriate length to reach from the charger to fuse holders, then crimp and solder on the eye terminals included with the FK40 kit. Note that you should not use standard blade fuses or light crimp terminals for any of the supply cables, as they will cause poor performance of the charger. You can then connect the supply and charge cable extensions to the DC to DC charger, again using heavy terminals which are first crimped and then soldered for a positive, long-lasting connection. Attach another heavy eye terminal to the charger's black negative cable and create 2 small loops to run from the positive battery terminals to the fuse holders, again using the same heavy crimp and solder terminals. For my installation, I don't need to connect the orange, blue or green wires, so I'm cutting them off to slightly different lengths, then encasing them in heat shrink tube. Refer to the charger manual to see if you need to use these wires. You should then put heat shrink tubing over all the joins and terminal connections on the cables to help prevent shorts and keep water out. Although I'm not installing any solar panels right now, I am going to attach an Anderson plug to the charger's solar input. To keep it neat, I'm running the negative wire from the Anderson plug back with the charger wiring. Finally, I'm applying split tubing over the top of all the wiring. This is a useful additional level of protection that helps prevent chafing and shorts due to vibration and movement in the vehicle. Once you're happy with the wiring, you can install the charger into the Long Ranger bracket. Align the charger as shown, then using a Phillips screwdriver and 10mm spanner, attach the charger to the bracket with the four supplied screws and nylock nuts. You can then move on to installing the charger assembly. Using 10 and 12mm spanners, remove the small bolt adjacent to the bonnet latch and the horn retaining bolt from the radiator support panel as shown. Then place the charger on top of the radiator support panel and run the cables across to the starting and auxiliary batteries and to the solar connection if required. You can then lower the charger into the gap between the grille and the radiator support panel. Using the supplied M6 by 20mm bolt and washer, loosely attach the lower mounting hole of the charger bracket to the captive nut in the vertical support member as shown. I'm also using this bolt to attach the earth wires for the charger and the Anderson solar connector. Using the factory bolts removed earlier, you can then attach the top of the charger bracket to the radiator support panel. Once all the bolts are installed, tighten them fully. Don't forget to reattach the horn when you're attaching the charger. Make sure all your cables are well secured to prevent chafing. You can then install a new auxiliary deep cycle battery. Lower it down into place, then secure using the factory battery clamp. Attach the charger wires to the FK40 fuse holder, then secure the fuse holder to the battery clamp using cable ties. You can then make the positive battery terminal connections. Next, install the new starting battery and secure it in place with the factory clamp. As with the auxiliary battery, connect the wiring to the fuse holder, then secure the holder to the battery clamp with cable ties. You can then make all the required connections to the positive terminal of the starting battery. Finally, reconnect the negative terminals on both the starting and auxiliary batteries. You can then start the vehicle and check the correct operation of the Redarc charger by observing the LEDs on the top of the unit. The vehicle LED should illuminate, along with the correct profile LED. The stage LED will flash depending on the charge status of the battery. The next step in the installation is to make a viewing window in the factory trim cover, so that you're able to monitor the charger status LEDs. Affix the template supplied with the Long Ranger bracket onto the trim cover, then drill out two small holes in the marked positions. Enlarge the holes to 12mm before cutting out the section between the holes to create the viewing window. The only remaining step is to refit the trim panel to the vehicle using the original clips as shown. If you break or lose any of the clips, you can find a link to buy the correct ones on the Project 200 website.
I hope you enjoyed the installation. As always, there's a lot of photos and plenty more information at project200.com.au, so please head over and have a read. See you next time.